very eventful Wednesday. Should I say eventful? Well, I think the word is being used loosely these days. But anyway, on this beautiful Wednesday, my name is Tina Pierce One, and the show is proudly sponsored by Metropolitan University, where we give you education. For now, then, let us get into some news. Does anyone want to crush on any woman today? No one? Not even Rebecca Kadaga? Nothing? Okay. It's all right. The masses have spoken. They're not crushing on any females. My name is Tina Pierce One, like I said. Let's get it. The year 2020, Obanga president, but one will get his 2020, it will go down in the books. Yo, I sat down yesterday and I was trying to understand, I was trying to backtrack on the things that happened in this year. You know, we had the forest fires down in Australia in January, then in February, there were locusts all over Africa, and then what was the month after that? January, February, March, April, May, June. There was COVID-19, which is still here. Then we have riots, we have protests, we have... Everything is going to the dogs, but that is not even as crazy as it sounds. Let me tell you what is crazy. Bana inajukira bulungi president wange, I think yali address ye yokubi. Bwe yimirira n'abagamba, mulekere okusaba abantu rent. They are not working. Where are they going to get that money from? And even after the lockdown, you cannot honestly ask them for rent ASAP Rocky like that. Mm-mm. Anyway, hey, so there is this landlord who took the time out to over frustration, over corona, that people are not thinking straight. So this guy apparently abadabanja omwezi gumu bweguti sabiri sesatu sikumi simwaka gumu bwedu. And he asked the tenant to pay rent, which the tenant, of course, couldn't do because they have also not been employed for a couple of months. When the tenant couldn't come through, this landlord set the house ablaze. As in kabiriti, gasolina. Na jocha. You have to be on some depressional ish. Or you have to be so demented in your mind to burn down your own building just because someone has not paid rent for a month, which you can gain back in the shortest time possible. I was like, wow, isn't that like a month they give you for security? So you just exempt this guy, chase him out of the house if you can, and then get someone to pay you all your month's rent you want, and then they put in like a security, which you put back on the other one, but not this guy, no. Why I've decided to talk about this is that there's a lot of desperacy that is going on. And why is this desperacy going on is because at times when our president stands up and says something, he has to clarify on it, and then after clarifying on it, the LDUs clarify on their own, the landlords clarify on their own, the tax master clarifies on his own. So you're going to have desperate things like this happening, and this is why I want to call upon my government to make sure that if you think right now the only problem Uganda has is differentiating an arcade from a mall, you have got to be wrong and, well, stupid at the same time, if I have to say that, because omuntu tokenda mugamba not to ask for rent, because rent oyo naye kwabadalia sicho. Ate n'oli gw'oyagala asasule rent. Naye tasobola kuwa eyo rent kubanga naye abadde takola kwabadalia. So, either you come up with something solid for us, government, or we're going to have situations like this. Next thing you're going to know is we're going to have anarchy. People are going to start beating people up in houses because baba banjizwe miezi ng'etaano. Kati imagine omuntu ayagenda mu corona. Ngalandi rodi yali amubanje miezi mukaga. Utekeko nejine satualizi sasula. Like, these are the things I was telling people at the beginning of this pandemic when it broke, all hell broke loose. And I said, you are still complaining about lockdowns and quarantine and facial masks and hand sanitizer. There is post-COVID. And it is on our door, it is knocking like this. These are the things I told people to look into, but they did not. Now landlords are losing their crazy ish. Tenants are losing their ish. Businesses are falling apart. Everything is just everything. Nzemba ndensaba. I'm nearly directly responsible for tenants and roads. Which ministry? It's just sad. It's really sad. But on a real note, though. On a for real note. Mr. President, tuwade tu sabo jotu adulesinge one last time. Nayenga, you know how Ugandans have been complaining that every time the president comes, atuwa A or B. Kati yaze tacha damu ya the previous one. Nayenze mbade nsaba tu didem bia yogera. Speech ayoku bia. Speech number two, just that one. So that people can find their footing. It's crazy, man. Ayotuveo. Someone attacked me on, I think it was Twitter, because I'm constantly, they say I'm attacking artists, but I'm not. I'm just being honest. I don't know why Ugandans have a problem. When someone is being honest, you call it rude. When someone is speaking their truth, you call it obuswab. When someone is speaking the truth, you're like, echechkazi chivuma. No, it's because you are used to people sugarcoating ish for you. Anyway. Then Sophie Gombia comes out. Sophie Gombia see Abakulira. Something, association artist, something. And she came out and she made statements that I was like, wow, they're just seeing it now. She came out and she said, Bananga, Abayimbi, Bali Kubona, Bonateba Inacha, Kuliakuba, they cannot perform. Katibagenda Tandika Basula, oh, Bagenda Basulanga, oh, way, but there is an artist who they threw out of a house worth 500k. Bali Mamanyameka. Nyezemeka. Huh? Esatu? Kamuchitun. Zebali. Siyo yo kamisara. Kamisara itali mulago yetu jamuwa gira kenda. Anyway. And she goes ahead and she's like, I think it's about time that artists learned how to live in their means. I swear. Nandi situ se. Nemu kubira mungalo lakona deo kute chikupo chachaya and I didn't find that very important. Anywho. Dear musician, comedian, bouncer, bartender, and even another video, Bivulu promoters, Banji, Bawera, no, Bawera, saloons, gym, arcade. At this point, life is a hard. Nekanta ni kena bayimbi bangi. Bayimbi mwanza sola na basa asira. Sisobola. Tewali muntu wa menyo mutima. Ngo muyimbi okunga mbambo mwavu. One, abayimbi beba chansi nzo mtase sula taxes. Kubivyulubia. Most of you guys are paid in cash. Abayimbi beba gai abakuata omudidi gwa sente in the shortest time possible. How? Let me explain it to you. In Kampala on Friday, let's say Waiki Benda. Waiki Benda can perform on Friday in Kampala. Emirundi ejo? Every in one night. The list of his, I'm giving him as an example. The list of his kabooking fee. Butano no kuambuka. Butano no kuambuka. Sitcha. Nakola milioni kumi muluna kwa, that is Friday. Ku Saturday, najivuga najolesa ginger. E ginger nakubayo shezo between Saturday and Sunday. Kati Sunday night, on his way back, na imirirako kafunda olibera obo fundo bubayita yita. Ngabako yebaku tusebaba deku socket. Nayona itira yona kwatayo kakoteyo. That man is, or that man or that woman is going to get that money and walk comfortably either to their bank account or put it under their bed without having to think much about anything. And you know what's funny? Is that it's every weekend. Ongambo chio performing buli weekend. No, buli weekend nge chitono chofu na jemidioni meka kumi munana. Kale katuteke kumunana. Not a sobola kubera ko with enough savings to run you through 3 months. 3 months. You are the people giving this music business a bad name. Emyeze satu tubalabye mukutuse, mutuyana, mukaba, musainize zi petition. I Other than sitting back and asking yourself, okay, how can I use my art, my talent to gain me money during this time? Muli wana mtu karibida. Pagenu bako ba mayumba. Number one, musicians, please stop living out of your means. Please stop living outside your means. Nchidemu, stop living outside your means. Financial literacy is a serious thing. Osango muyimbi katituve kubali bemba dengamba abalina send. Osango muyimbi kangambenga lirupazo. Nga weekend, okulimba kubi. Mwebi yabivulubi yona. Nga yako zae mituwale uje ngaga, atano. E mituwale atano mu community yangi, ne mu country yangi. It is some money. It is some money, it can move and shake. Atano, gwe ingida na atano mubalola venga bujonona. Hey! Lirupazo na kwa leo, she's an example too. Na akoze sa emitwalo atano, weekend nga zeba musasude. Ne next weekend neba muongere ndala. Then you find a little puzzle living in a house. On his car 500k weekly. Living in a house of 1.2. The math doesn't add up. Not for me. At least not for me. So, and I know way too many musicians who barely raking that much for them to be spending that much. No sanga ngo muyimbi, ye mumwezi wetuba tubaze ze yakoze in a month. Nga he could have probably grossed about 12 to 15 million, right? Omuyimbi ngo yali allowed to live in a house of 500k a month. But your gross monthly as an artist is between 2 million, 3 million, 5 million. And you want to live in a house of 500k, Abi, what is your problem? What is your problem? Ate mwina no muze gugena ne mwe wole bintu. Ne mtusubula bisa suria. Now I'm giving you a wake up call. You have got to learn how to financially discipline yourselves as artists. Kuba fenga Uganda at this point in our life. You will be shocked, but I know you won't be, that we are not going to help anyone. We are not going to start a GoFundMe. We are not going to write a hashtag. We is dealing with our issues. So please, madam, musicians, comedians, simanya bouncers, bartenders, saloons, gym instructors, schools, bana imbade neira vidaba masumeru nabo kamba preparing them. Nabo bo they know how to live in their means. The artists were living out of their means issues. What are we going to use all these empty schools for? Warehouses. Imagine little acorns in Chisasi being a warehouse. Huh? A big warehouse. Oh, come on. Because that's another thing I'm going into. Teachers. Nabe njale bakala kata. Na yabo nsobola balwa anirira. Because even it was before COVID, they were still being underpaid. Something goes for doctors and nurses. Abobo, I will stand proud and hold my hand up and say they need to get paid more. But artists, comedians. Anyway, I was just saying, learn how to live within your means. For all of you who have bookers, you know you don't have gigs, be an Uber driver. Do you know how dope it would be for me to call an Uber? And let's say, who can I disturb now? King Michael. Imagine me. Ha! Ah, and the myth picks me up. Hey, you are joking. Imagine calling an Uber and Navio comes through. It is called a day job, a hustle. You all need to get one of those. Mwena mwina opu moto kapa mwabuli yao, tebina chepukula, mvugama moto kamufunecho kulia mlikina utukabila. Mwena mulina equipment in your houses that can actually be rented out for different things, not necessarily outdoor parties, but all these different media houses right now are running on fumes too. So we can use all this stuff. Mubi guze, mubi tunde, I'm just saying. But what you're not going to do is come out here. Mutokabi dide. Nganye. Done. Anyway, nange njogera nyo, 30 minutes, I need to take a breather. I notice most of you think we just, when we do the first part of the show, we are done. No, we are not. I'm taking a breather. So let's be back right after these messages. I'm before I could, you know, get into the irrelevant stuff that's still been happening, you know, within us, Banange, Salvador, Patrick Salvador Idringi actually posted something on his platform. And this story has spiraled out of control like for about 3 days. Now, you know me. I'm going to take my time with the story just to see what angle, what direction, what, where, how it's growing, build it, that whole thing. So the story apparently has a certain girl called Thelma and some other guy. It's a guy, Sam, to get denarinya. That's how bored I am. Now, apparently they are claiming that Thelma raped certain guy. She comes back and says, nah, we was drunk. It was a different story. Because of her not knowing how to deal with social media, she also comes back and she starts saying things like, yeah, I raped you. Yeah, I'm sick. Yeah, I got tested. I'm like, right. Then, that is not just recent. Apparently, they are claiming it was date rape. They were together, the guy was drunk, he was under the influence, and apparently she raped him. Then Shiva Kasumba takes the opportune moment just to catch a little bit of likes and followers, and she posts up the same story with very, very, very big words, and she says this girl is she's a rapist, she's all these things. This girl has tried to defend herself. She's been having a back and forth with Shiva Kasumba online to a point that Shiva Kasumba actually blocked her as of today morning. Now, what? I could have done the story from any other angle because we've had these stories. I think a couple of months back, we had the whole, you know, rape. It's a very sensitive issue, if you ask me, but as I'm scrolling through the comment section on Twitter that has Shiva Kasumba's tweet saying this girl is all these things, in jumps Shiloh trying to reply or respond to a tweet, and she's saying, oh, what? Because everybody's like, there are videos, there's audio that she did what she did. Everybody's sending them around. Then Shiloh Kasumba jumps onto her comment section on her post, and she's like, what? Can you please send me that audio and that video? Because I just saw it on Salvador's wall. That is when I was mad. I was mad. I personally know a friend of mine who was falsely accused of rape just because his chick was having a bad day. So she rallied up the troops and they went on social media. And by morning come, the world had bought the story that he's actually a rapist. Where do I get it, Akati? He doesn't have a job. No one wants to hire him. No one wants to be around him. Even when we made the clarification and it came out that it was actually, it was just all, you know, put together. So I need for people to understand before you run to social media and begin calling people all sorts of different things, you're gonna come and give me some receipts. Now you have this trickster. You went on Twitter and you said a girl is so many things, but on that same saying, you're the same person asking them to send you evidence. So what was your basis to call her a rapist? And this one goes to everyone on social media. There are people's lives at risk. Whatever transpired between these two, I do not know. Because all I know for a fact, if this guy says he was raped, he wouldn't be doing this. He would be at a police station getting his, you know, he would be at a police station writing down statements. That would be us. And before I came in here, someone called and they said he was ready to come and do a tell-all at my sister radio station. And I'm like, so why you raped or not? That's the conversation I'm asking with the person telling me they're going to bring them. And they're like, apparently, why you raped or not? Because you're the victim. Now you have a minute. You want to come out and speak up on it as the victim. I respect that, that's bravery beyond anything. But which is it? And same thing goes for Thelma. This young girl, Atechinyiza, banabana babakubyemitwe, who are bringing very big intellectual minds to actually speak on it, are all young. They're all young kids. You might find they're actually social media influencers. You know, I noticed the streets The streets of Twitter have their own code. That's just it. You'll find the most irrelevant person on Twitter being at the tongue of everybody else's mouth. So, Thelma, you need to first sit off social media. If you are stupid enough to just sit back and think this is not going to affect you, honey, this is not the time for you to be sending audio notes making fun and saying, okay, I told him I was HIV positive just because I was pissed. Are you stupid? Because if you tell someone something like that, I can use that against you in the courts of law. That is not just recklessness. That is attempted murder. That could actually go down as first degree manslaughter, if you ask me. In any way, like the worst sentence for it, because if you willingly knew that you were HIV positive and you slept with somebody and did just stop at sleeping with somebody, you told them I slept with you and I was HIV positive, that is a crime. It's a crime, a big crime. So why are these kids being this stupid? Let me tell you, stop giving these kids relevance. Stop it. Lives are being ruined. Now for Thelma and this guy, Iwe guy, you're saying you were raped. Please walk down to a police station like I told you last time. Social media is not going to help you. All right? Now, walk down to a police station. Write down your statement. Open a police file. Let the courts and, you know, justice take its course. Thelma, what I wanted with this story was to show you people that people like Sheila Gashumba, people like Salvador, people with a big following, once you step up and you say certain things, I need for you to understand that we take them for solid truth. So before you come out and say somebody is a rapist, before you come out and say somebody is a thief or a thug, please have your receipts by you. When I saw this trending on Twitter because of Sheila Gashumba, I thought the trick had video evidence, audio, write down. She was standing in the room. She witnessed it. That's what I thought. But she's the same trick in the comment section asking, "Bana ikampere zendabia bulabi post." So you just saw a post and you jumped on it because you want likes and follows, not forgetting two individual lives are at stake here. When I say at stake, reputations are going to be messed up. Right? Now, I know it's been very many days after the fact. I'm just saying, yo, Uganda, mufunebi yokola. Why do you let these people? I am so disappointed. I am so disappointed. But not in Sheila. Sheila is, that one is a one-hit wonder. Yeah, buli bwalabanga mumwera bidenga afuna yokabukira. But for you, Salvador, I want better from Salvador, because you know Salvador is one of those guys. You have a kubuli la kuwane receipt. Nze walai Salvador wana vayo na mpazi receipt yezi singa ko zinezili ku social media. What I mean by real receipts, I want real receipts that can actually take me or take anybody down the justice lane, you know? They have to be so solid that immediately we are going to open up a case file and we are going to charge this rapist. It doesn't matter if she's a female or she's man. Most of you are trying to turn this into a gender thing. Rape is rape, period. That's just what I feel. Rape is rape, whether it's female, whether it's male. Nage ne mubukayo, ne mogere ebintu nga bino. And then you just leave it to float in the surface like that. Let it marinate so that the other twits who are bored on Twitter can start also coming up with their own receipts. Listen here. You people are going to learn what they mean by protecting your identity. That is the next crucial step to being human now for Ugandans. You need to learn how to protect your identity. Because at this point, people are ruining people's lives for just a click on the like button, that heart-shaped Twitter thing. For just a retweet. If you are going to come out and say somebody is a rapist, Sheila Gashumba, please, a very family, you are very, very firm with the conviction. You're like, yes, it's the truth, this chick. Tomorrow morning, Sheila Gashumba, wake up, send us audios, send us videos or send us photographs of you in the room as the act was going down so that we can also find out how you knew all this and did not just put it out there. Why can't we just have some other things to talk about? What else is there in this country? Because I feel like I'm losing my ish. I can't talk about the artists because they're doing some dumb stuff all the time. I can't talk about the politicians because they get too sensitive when we say the truth about them. I can't talk about the irrelevant people, well, because they are irrelevant. So I'm left with you guys. This is my pool. Ugh. Disgusted. Anyway, that's been my time. All I'm saying for this story, I just want, if it's going to keep going on or, you know, and let's see this one through. Let's see this one through. If she is indeed a rapist, let us make sure she is charged. Let us make sure she is taken wherever she's supposed to be taken. But if she is not, I repeat. Now, this one should start, I think we need to put it into consideration. If she is not, and evidence says she did not rape, evidence says he lied, he was not raped, I want bully cheese. Akute faces abana abantu babiri nakola posts ku Facebook saying they are either a victim or saying they are either the rapist with so much love. Mwebe bagendo okusiba. Anyway, byange on this very polite Wednesday. At TinaVS1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop under TinaVS1. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's a TinaVS1 with an H. Tomorrow is a Thursday. I wanted to throw back to something that, you know, something that gives us a good laugh. It's been for a minute. So yeah, hit me up in the comment section. Let me know what you think we should be throwing back to tomorrow. For now, though, I'm out. I'll catch you on the flip side. Peace.